Okay, dear students, in the last class we have finished 4.4 exercise. Okay, now in 4.5 exercise, that means before 4.5 exercise, what are the concepts are there? 4.5 concepts. So let us see adjoint and inverse of a matrix. Okay, now we are in determinants, but we have written matrix. Why? Why? Because matrix or determinant are interrelated, or else we can say that determinant come from matrix only, but square matrix you have to take 2 by 2, 1 by 1 or 3 by 3 like that. Okay, that we know very well. Adjoint and inverse of matrix we are going to study. Okay, but it is related with the determinant also. Why? Because without determinant inverse we are not studying here. See, without determinant inverse we have already studied in matrices. But in this class, we will study matrix, inverse of matrix with determinant. That means with the help of determinant, we are going to find inverse of a matrix, like I want to say. Okay. And what are the default? Default are all our square matrices. And if two matrix we are comparing for operation, then two matrix should be of same order. That you should keep in our mind. That means what I want to say, if operation between two matrices are there, that means two of matrices should be of same order. 2 by 2, 2 by 2. 3 by 3, 3 by 3. Like that I want to say. Square matrices I already said. Why? Because without square matrix, determinant are not going to come. This is the precondition. Okay? Okay. Let us see what is adjoint and inverse of matrix, how to find. Already inverse of matrix we have seen. But how to find inverse of matrix rather than elementary operation or transformation? See, earlier we find inverse of matrix with elementary operation or transformation. That was a lengthy process. Or else we can say that is a different process. You see, you compare whether that is a lengthy or this is a lengthy. Okay? Let us find adjoint. And before finding adjoint of a matrix, see, interrelated, I said, determinant and matrices. See, when we find this cofactors, you tell me now. I am writing cofactors. See, this is element, this is cofactor. Is it okay? And this is matrix. Or simply A also matrix. Matrix, element, cofactor, matrix, determinant. All are different here. See, determinant is different. Matrix, these two are same, but these two are different. Element, these two are different. You understand the concept? Then you said to me, you tell me, when cofactor has come into picture, has it come in matrices? No. Cofactor came into picture in determinants only. That means adjoint of a matrix, but with the help of cofactor we are finding. That's what I am telling. See, here, with the help of determinant, we are doing some operations on matrices, like we can think. Okay? That means cofactor was there in, cofactor is there in determinants only, but adjoint is a matrix. Adjoint is a matrix. And how to find, how to understand that you observe carefully. Okay. First, let me write in simplest way one definition or something like, not a definition, statement like I say. One statement I am writing. You see how I am writing. Okay, first you study the statement, then we will go further. Adjoint is a transposed matrix of cofactors. Okay, now we know cofactor also, we know transposition also. What is transpose? Transpose also, transpose from matrices, we have studied concept. Cofactors from determinants we have studied. That means you have to transpose. One matrix. What is that matrix? Matrix with cofactors. You see, I am writing here. 2 by 2 I am writing now. You see, A, B, C, D is a matrix. Say A. Okay. Now, I write A transpose, A dash. Or else you can keep A power T also. Both are same, but this is less practice. This is in less practice, A power T. A transpose is equal to how to write? First row is going to become first column. Second row is going to become second column. This is called transpose. That we already know. See, I have taken 2 by 2. Why? Because 3 by 3. Why should we waste time? We already know about. Same, you can write in 3 by 3 also. A, B, C, A, B, C. D, E, F, D, E, F. G, H, I, G, H, I. Okay? First row, first column. Second row, second column. Third row, third column. If you write like that, that is going to be called as transpose of matrix A. Okay? This is transpose. Cofactors. Cofactor we already know, we can find after minors or without minors also. See, if you get some practice, then without finding minors also cofactor directly you can write. But you should be very careful. Okay? Okay. Now, see, I am writing one thing. A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. This is a 3 by 3 matrix. Okay? Say this is 3 by 3 matrix. Okay. Now with a single step I am writing, how I am writing, you see. Adjoint A. You see how to write representation adjoint A? This one. Small a d j, capital A. Adjoint A. Okay? Adjoint A is equal to. See, this is row, but column you have to write, but cofactors. See how I am writing. A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Okay. This is adjoint. Adjoint of a matrix. We will go inverse afterwards. Adjoint of a matrix. Adjoint is a transposed matrix of cofactors. See, here cofactors are there. Capital A is cofactor, small a is element. Okay. A11, 12, 13, if you write in a horizontal position, then it is a matrix or normal position. But A11, 12, 13, if you write in vertical column wise, then this is going to be called as transposed. You see, this has been written in different way. Row, column, first row, first column, second row, second column, third row, third column, but cofactors, these is elements, okay, that means what you have to do, they give matrix, then you find cofactors first, A11, A12, A2, A13, all cofactors you find, but after finding the cofactors, write in transposed way, normal way also you can write. Cofactor matrix, we don't have any notation. That is why normally cofactor matrix we don't write. But adjoint we can write. That means transposed cofactors. Okay? Adjoint is a transposed matrix of cofactors. You understand now? Okay? Now cofactors we know very well. How to write cofactor? You see how I am writing? A11 cofactor is equal to minus 1 whole power 1 plus 1 into M11 minor how it comes minor if you close M11 is equal to A22 A23 A32 A33 that means you have to write A22 A33 minus A23 A32 AD minus BC okay. You have to close like this. This already I have told. Okay. For A11. If you close like this. Then this determinant you have to write. A22 AD minus BC. If you write that is going to be called as minor. See cofactor means. Putting symbol or sign. For minor that's all. Minus 1 whole power 1 plus 1. Means here we are going to make only sign. For minor. For cofactor, there is no change of operation, only for sign, change of sign, that's all. Okay? Now you see, theoretically we understood the adjoint of a matrix 3 by 3. Adjoint is there for 2 by 2 also, adjoint is there for 3 by 3 also. What we do, we go for 2 by 2 matrix first, easily, 2 by 2 matrix, adjoint, with real numbers. Again, we go for 3 by 3 with real numbers, okay? Adjoint only. Inverse we will go afterwards. Why? Because before inverse, again, one or two concepts are there. Okay? Let us go adjoint of a 2 by 2 matrix. Okay? What I am writing now, you see, adjoint of a 2 by 2 matrix. Adjoint A of 2 by 2 matrix. Okay. See, let me write 2 by 2 matrix is like this. A is equal to A, B, C, D. Okay. A, B, C, D we have taken. First, what you have to find? Cofactors you have to find. Let us find cofactors. Cofactors you find. Why? Because only 4 are there. Easily you can find. Finding cofactors in this one. 2 by 2 is very easy. Okay, how I am finding, you see. See, cofactor you can find after minor also or direct also. Direct means carefully you have to write. How I am writing, you observe now. How to save the time and all. Okay. Okay, first cofactor is A11. See, A11 means, you see, 1 plus 1, 2, minus 1 power 2, plus. That is why you have to first write plus. Then see, A11, if you close automatically, D will be there. Then you write D. You understand now how it has come? Okay, next you write A12. A12 means minus 1 whole power 1 plus 2. Minus 1 cube. That means minus should come. That means you put first minus. Then you see A12, if you close B row, B column, then C will be there. Minus C. Okay? Then you come for A 2 1 also negative only. Why? Minus 1 whole power 2 plus 1. Minus 1 whole power 2 plus 1. Okay. Negative, but A21 means, see, C you are closing. C column, C row, if you close, B will be there. Minus B. Then A22. 1 1 1 2 2 1 2 2. Okay. A22. A22 means 2 plus 2, 4. Minus 1 power 4. Positive. That means you first keep positive. Why? Because you are not finding your minus. That is why this position you have to follow. D you are closing. D if you close, A will be there. A. You see now, cofactors you received. Okay. Now, how to write this adjoint? I am writing, you see. Adjoint of A is equal to A11, A12, A21, A22. Do you understand now? Actually, if element means A11, A12 like this, it will go. Why? Because first row, first column. Now second row, first column has come, you see. But it is in second row, first row only. Why? Because we have transposed. Okay? A11, A12 like this you have to write in column wise. But these are cofactors. That means you have already transposed. Okay. Now see, what is A11? A11 is D. What is A12? See, A21. RSC, row you write column like, that will be very easy. Minus C and minus B, A. You understand now? See, A, A, B, C, D, adjoint A, D, minus B, minus C, A. A, A, B, C, D, adjoint A, D, minus B, minus C, A. I am talking about 2 by 2 matrix only. 2 by 2 matrix, adjoint. Okay. See, adjoint has come. D minus B minus C. Okay. See, every time for 2 by 2 matrix, do you need for doing this calculation for cofactors or any other way is there? You see, what we have done here? AD we have reversed. You see, AD you reverse. Remaining two, you keep only minus symbol. That's all. AD you have reversed and you have remaining two, BC, minus symbols you have kept, minus sign. Okay, like that you can do. you see AD, you have reversed and minus symbol you have kept. Okay. One example I will take 2 by 2. And rather than this cofactor practice, I will do with this reversal and symbol. Okay.
Okay. You see, let A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay. Now I am writing adjoint A. Without finding cofactors, I am writing. How I am writing, you see. Without finding cofactors, with one step I am writing.
You see, 1, 4 I am reversing. 4, 1.
Remaining 2 minus I am keeping. Minus 2, minus 3. You understand now?
You see, 1, 4 I have reversed. That's all. 4, 1. AD I have reversed. Remaining BC I have kept minus signs. Plus 2, plus 3. Minus 2, minus 3. See, what if it is already minus 3? Then here it will be plus 3. What if here minus 4? Then here minus 4.
You understand now? That is the logic.
If minus 1 minus 4 is there, then minus 4, 1 will come here. And 2 minus 3 is there, minus 2 plus 3 will come. That's all. Why? Because you have to add symbol or change the symbol or sign of this
2 by 2 matrices.
Now, in this procedure, you are going to save the time. You did not go for cofactors.
Okay.
See, if they ask find cofactor and minor and write adjoint means, then there is no way. You have to find minor also, cofactor also, then you have to write this adjoint. Okay. Now, what we have done? We have learnt to find the adjoint of a 2 by 2 matrix. Let us go for 3 by 3 matrix also. Adjoint of a 3 by 3 matrix. Okay. Let A is equal to 1, minus 2, 0, 3, minus 1, 4, minus 1, minus 3, 0. Okay, see, this is a 3 by 3 matrix.
Okay, now we have to find adjoint A.
Adjoint A we will find here at last, but before that we have to find cofactors or minors. Minors also there, cofactors are there. Without minor I am going to find cofactor. You see, transposed matrix of cofactors is adjoint. Okay, now I am finding, see, as a element A11, A12, A13, but in adjoint A11, A12, A13, like this in column wise it will come, but those are cofactors, capital A. Okay, let us find capital A. Let us find capital A 1 1. Capital A 1 1 is equal to. Okay, see 1 1 is there. That means plus you have to take. Okay, then you are closing this. You see 0 minus of minus 12 plus 12. That means you are writing plus 12. That's all directly. Okay, how I have written? See, first one I am writing here. You see A 1 1 is equal to minus 1 whole power 1 plus 1 into. Okay. You see, 1, 1, you have closed it. That means minus 1, 4, minus 3, 0 will be there. That is equal to minus 1 whole square into, you see, minus 1 into 0, 0, minus of minus 12, plus 12. That means plus 12 will be there. Here also plus will come. Plus 12. Like this I have written. These steps you can save. Okay? Remaining all directly I am writing. Okay? With minor means like this you have to find. Without minor directly I am finding. Okay, this is A11. Write down now A12. A12 means 2 you are closing. Okay, see here 1 2 means 1 plus 2, 3. Minus symbol has to come first. Okay, then you see 0 minus of minus 4 plus 4. 0 plus 4 is plus 4. That means minus of plus 4. That's all. Okay. Write down A13. 0 if you close automatically. See, here minus 9, minus 1. Okay, minus 10. Directly I am writing minus 10. Why? Because you see, 3 into minus 3, minus 9, minus of 1, minus 1 into minus 1, plus 1. That means total minus 10 it's going to become. Okay. Okay. Outside. Outside plus symbol I have to keep. A13. 3 plus 1, 4. Plus sign. Plus sign. That is why minus. Let it be like that only. Minus 9, minus 10. Minus 1. Plus 10. Minus 10. Minus 10 with outside plus symbol means minus 10 only it will come. Okay. Okay. Come to A21, see, minus you have to keep first, then you see, 0 only, 0 means you don't keep any minus, okay, that's not a good practice, okay, 2, plus, A22, okay, 2 means plus, okay, plus, you see, plus shape you are going to close, that means 0, again it is 0, again you don't keep plus. A23 minus 23 means 2 plus 3 minus 23. Okay, see minus 3 minus 2 minus 5 minus of, you see first minus is there outside, but you see minus 3. Okay, minus of plus 2. Okay, minus 1 into minus 2 plus 2. Minus of plus 2, minus 5. Minus 5 of minus 5, plus 5. Totally, I am writing plus 5 directly. You understand now? Okay? Okay. Now, write down A31. See, A31 means plus first you write. Why? Because 3 plus 1 is 4. Okay? Now, you are going to close this 1 and this row and column. And see, minus 8. 0 minus 8 only, that means plus is going to become minus 8. Inside minus has come already, minus 8. Okay, now go for A32. Minus you write first. 3 plus 2 is 5, minus 1 power 5, that means minus will come. Okay, A32. See, minus 3 you close by column and row. 4 minus 0, 4 only will come, that means minus 4. That's fine. Okay, 4 minus 0 is correct. Next you go for A33, plus will come, plus symbol, and you see what will come. See, minus 1 plus 6, minus 1 minus of minus plus 6, 6 minus 1 5, 5 will come here. Okay. Okay, now see cofactors you are having. Adjoint, how to write? See, A11, A12, A13, this row, we have to write in column. Okay? Always try to write like this only. A11, A12, A13, horizontally you write. Next line you write A21, A22, A23. Next you write A31, A22, A33. Then those again you write in column wise. In matrix. Here directly you are writing. Okay? Okay, write down now. Adjoint A is equal to, okay, write down 12 minus 4 minus 10 0 5 minus 8 minus 4 5. Okay, this will be adjoint A. This is matrix A, this is adjoint A. You see how different it has become? Earlier here was zeros, but here now these two are zeros. Okay, you see how what all changed like numbers. Adjoint is the having that speciality. Okay, you see this is adjoint. Okay, now we came to know that how to find adjoint of 2x2 and 3x3. See, for 2x2, there is a single step process is there, shortcut method. But for 3x3, there is no shortcut method. You have to find cofactors and you have to transpose those cofactors. Write in matrix form. Okay, this is the procedure of finding adjoint of a 3x3 matrix. Okay, let us go. Next concept, write down this. Theorem we will take. That theorem is very useful for finding even afterwards inverse also. That theorem without proof we will take, but with verification we will do. That means one example we will take and we will verify that theorem also.
Okay, what is the theorem? See, I am writing that theorem. A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A, that is equal to determinant A I. Okay. See, this theorem always, I am already said, by default, if 2 comes, all 2 should be in same order, same square. Square already there. Okay, while studying the determinants itself, we have said that square matrices only will become determinants. Now we are studying interrelated determinants and matrices. Like, because see, here determinant has come. Okay, huh. That means all are here same order matrices. Okay, I said matrix or matrices, but here you are seeing determinant, then you may get confused. Sir, here determinant is there, you are telling matrices. You see, simply observe here, determinant A means only one value will come. That will be like scalar. That means scalar multiplying with the identity matrix like. If that scalar is 3, then identity matrix how it will come? 3, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 3. 3 by 3 means. If all are 2 by 2 matrices, then determinant value is minus 2. Then what will come? Minus 2, 0, 0, minus 2. That's all. Okay, you understand? That means here for the namesake determinant is there, but this determinant is a scalar like acting. It is acting like a scalar. Okay? Finally, all are in matrices form only. This is also matrix, this is also matrix, this is also matrix. Why? Because we have seen. Now you tell me adjoint we have found, 2 by 2 also, 3 by 3 also. Have you changed any order? 2 by 2 matrix adjoint to 2 by 2 has come. 3 by 3 matrix adjoint also, 3 by 3 matrix has come. There is no change of order. 2 by 2 matrix to 2 by 2 matrix. 3 by 3 matrix to 3 by 3 matrix only will come. That means here also, A and adjoint A means if 2 by 2 is there, both are 2 by 2. If 3 by 3 is there, both are 3 by 3. Okay? If these are 3 by 3, then I also 3 by 3 have to take. Determinant, whether it may be 2 by 2 or 3 by 3, finally one value will come like a scalar. Then you can multiply. Okay? This statement or theorem is very important. Based on this statement only, we are going to get inverse of matrix. Okay? That is why this is very important. Note down this. And rather than proof, we will take one example, verification. Okay? Okay. See, verification also, exercises and all, see, 18 questions are there in exercise. What we do, whatever the verification here we do, we do with 2 by 2, simple. One last one, inverse, we will take 3 by 3. Remaining all, 2 by 2 only we will do. We will finish as early as possible. And we go for exercise. In exercise, plenty of examples are, plenty of questions are there on 3 by 3. There we will do more. Okay, see, verifying, I am verifying the statement or theorem with 2 by 2. Okay. 2 by 2 matrix I will take. Why? Because these all belongs to matrix only. Okay, 2 by 2 matrix I am taking. You see, A is, say, 1. See, for verifying this statement or theorem, I am taking one matrix. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1 minus I have taken. Okay? Okay, this is matrix A. Adjoint A also you want, right? Adjoint A. Adjoint A, I am putting comma here. Okay, adjoint A is equal to, see how I am writing. First I am reversing this AD. 4, 1 it is going to become. And changing the say sign. That means if you change minus 2, 2 will come become. This is minus 3 is going to become. Are these okay? Both. A and adjoint A. Now one by one we see. A into adjoint A we will multiply. We will keep one side. Adjoint A into A also we will multiply. We will see whether both are same or not. Done. And determinant also we will find. And determinant with the identity matrix we will multiply. We will see all three. Okay. Let us find one by one. Okay. First I am doing A into adjoint A. A adjoint A is equal to. You see here only in front of left right are there. Directly we can do this process. Okay. Okay. See how I am finding. 1 into 4, 4. Minus 2 into minus 3 plus 6. That means 4 plus 6. 2 minus 2. 12
माइनस 12 6 प्लस 4 ओके
ओके
नाउ राइट डाउन दिस वैल्यू 10 0 0 10 ओके फाइनली ए इनटू एडजॉइंट ए वैल्यू हैज कम वी कैन से दिस इज 10i इज इट ओके why because see 1001 i but if you multiply with 10 10 0 0 10 will come that means this is like 10i la not like this is 10i that means finally determinant also should come 10 that we will see afterwards now a into adjoint a adjoint a into a also you multiply adjoint a into a adjoint a into a is equal to now you see how to change that means first you write this one 4 2 minus 3 1 into a 1 minus 2 3 4 okay that is equal to okay write down now okay 4 into 1 4 plus 6 minus 8 plus 8 minus 3 plus 3 plus 6 plus 4 okay okay now write down 10 0 0 10
okay now you see A into adjoint A 10 0 0 10 adjoint A into A also 10 0 0 10 that means both are same A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A that means these two have found verified let us see determinant A into I also okay determinant A how to find AD minus BC why because 2 by 2 is there determinant A is equal to AD minus BC that's all okay AD means 4 minus of minus plus 6 3 into 2 6 4 plus 6 is equal to 10 that means determinant A has come 10 okay now determinant A I is equal to 10 into 1001 that is equal to 10 0 0 10 is it okay adjoint A into adjoint A that is equal to determinant A into I okay now see determinant has become scalar that's all Scalar, if you multiply automatically, matrix only will come. You see, all are 2 by 2 matrices only. You have not changed. You are unable to change. That's all. This is the process. This is a system. Okay. Now, we can say that we have verified this statement or theorem. Okay. Adjoint A into A is equal to A into adjoint A. That is equal to determinant A into I. This we have verified. Like that, we can say. Okay. Now another concept is there singularity. See, we finally chapter name is inverse. Yes, sorry, concept name is adjoint and inverse. Inverse we have to find. Inverse before finding inverse, what are all requirements? All we will see. Now singularity of matrix has the that concept. Let us study the singularity of a matrix. Singularity of a matrix. What is this singularity? Whether it may be 2 by 2 or 3 by 3, if determinant is going to become 0, that is called singular matrix. Okay, I am writing like this, you see. If determinant A is equal to 0, then A is singular. If determinant A is not equal to 0, then A is non-singular matrix. You understand now the concept? Determinant A is 0, then A is called singular matrix. What is the singular matrix? One example I am giving you, see. 2, 4, 8, 1. If I write automatically, what will become AD minus BC? 2 into 4 minus 8 into 1. That is equal to 8 minus 8. That is equal to 0. This matrix is a singular matrix.
You understand now? If I change this 1 as 2, then this is 16.
8 minus 16 minus 8. See,
that may be minus 8 or minus 2 or whatever it may be, but that should not be 0. If it is 0, that is singular matrix. Now here A is singular matrix. Why? Because determinant A has become 0,
AD minus BC.
For 3 by 3 also. 3 by 3 what will be there? See, already we have done, but I am not doing again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If you do this matrix, then we have done earlier. 0 has come. This is a singular matrix. Let us do. How much time it will take? It will take less only. Okay, you see. Plus 1 into 45 minus 48 minus 2 into 36 minus 42. Okay, then plus 3 into 32 minus 35. Okay, determinant is equal to, okay, see, for minus 3, okay. And you see, minus 6, but minus of minus plus will become plus 12. Okay, now you see, minus 3 into 3, minus 9. Okay, you see, minus 12 plus 12, that is equal to 0. Now we can say that this matrix is a singular matrix. You understand? Why we have to study singularity of matrix? Because... see, non-singular matrix, if A is equal to, see, for 2 by 2 I am telling, 2, 5, 1, 8. Here you see 2 into 5, 10, minus 8 into 1, 8, that is equal to 2. That means A is not equal to 0. That means this is non-singular. This is non-singular. This is singular, this is singular. Why we are studying singularity of matrix? Because non-singular matrices only having inverses. Invertible matrix, like we have studied concept. Okay, only square matrices should be there, and while elementary operation 0, 0, 0 if comes, rather than 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Zeros have come. In place of 1, 0 comes means there is no inverse, like we will write. Okay, now here also you see, if a matrix is a singular, then that doesn't have inverse. Condition of inverse is the matrix should be non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix means inverse will come. Why? Because afterwards I am going to derive one formula or statement for this inverse formula. In that formula, this determinant will come in denominator position. Denominator determinant is there means if determinant becomes 0 means 1 by 0, undefined, infinity or undefined. Undefined means normally that doesn't have inverse, like we can say. Okay, now this is the concept of singularity of a matrix. Okay, now see, another concept is there. See, two matrices are there, one A and B, both are singular matrices. If you multiply them, then whether singular matrix will come or non-singular matrix will come? Singular matrix only will come. That is also one theorem is there. I am writing that. Okay. Let me write that theorem. This is singularity or non-singularity matrix. You see, equal to 0, singular. That you keep in your mind. For matrix, inverse, that should not become 0. Don't kind of memorize both. You memorize only one. If determinant is equal to 0, that is called singular matrix. Then automatically you can write that, when equal to 0 is singular means, non-singular means that should not be equal to 0. Like that you can call. Okay. Let us go for another theorem. If A and B are singular, non-singular matrices. Why? Because for inverse, non-singular, if A and B are non-singular matrices of same order. Why? Because same order is important. I already told you in starting itself. All are square matrices, that I need not write again. All are square matrices. Okay.
all are square matrices and of same order, okay, A and B.
Okay. Then AB and BA are also non-singular matrices. This is also one theorem.
What you understand? That means you have got one 2 by 2 non-singular matrix. Another one 2 by 2 non-singular matrix is there, both A and B. If you multiply AB, the resultant AB is also non-singular matrix. BA, the resultant BA is also non-singular matrix. Okay, here after multiplication, the property of this singularity or non-singularity is not going to change. If those are non-singular, then non-singular only. Okay, that you have to keep in your mind. Okay, but here in this theorem, they are not telling that AB is equal to BA or something like. No, AB is not equal to GA, BA. Always in matrices. If those are equal to BA, AB is equal to BA, then the B may must be inverse. Okay, that theorem we already have studied in matrices. Okay, here we are not telling that AB is equal to BA, but what we are telling, if A is a non-singular matrix of 2 by 2 order, B is a non-singular matrix of 2 by 2 order, if you multiply AB, then AB should be 2 by 2 of non-singular matrix. Same order will come, even after multiplication also same order. Okay, A and B are also non-singular matrices of same order. You understand now?
Okay.
Let us go for another concept. Okay, see, another concept is there, theorem. Determinant AB is equal to determinant A into determinant B. This we will take one verification also. Okay, you see, AB determinant is there. That is equal to determinant A into determinant B. Okay. Now, you tell me determinant AB is equal to determinant B into determinant A. That also is right. Why? Because you see, final determinant itself is a number. Final value. Value means a real number. You can, AB is equal to BA, it is going to become. That is why A into B or B into A, you can write determinant. These determinants. Why? Because final determinant is a real number. Let us take two, see. How, when this is possible, both should be square matrices and both should be of same order. This is very important. I am not writing, but this should be. I need not write. These are the basic requirement. Square matrices, same order. When second one comes in, that also should be same order. Already square matrices. Okay. We will take one example. We will verify this. Okay. Let us verify. Determinant AB is equal to determinant A into determinant B. Why? Because while in questions like this, we can split. Okay? See, I am taking A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, but 1 minus I will take. Okay? B is equal to, say, 5, 6, say, minus 7, 8 I am taking. Okay? Now see, for both determinant A, determinant B, I will find and I will multiply. Or else AB I will do first. Here AB. AB is equal to. Why? Because first you have to find AB, then determinant you have to do. AB is equal to. Okay. Okay. 5 plus 14. Okay. Then 6 minus 16. Minus 16. Okay. Now 15 minus 28. 18 plus 32. Plus 32. 18 plus 32. Is it correct? 5 plus 14. Okay, that is correct. Then 6 minus 16. Okay, that is also correct. Then 15 minus 28. Okay, that is also correct. 18 plus 32. Okay. Now you write AB is equal to 14 plus 5, 19, and 6 minus 16 minus 13
sorry 10 minus 10 minus 10 okay and 15 minus 28 13 yes minus 13 50 okay now this is a matrix then what about determinant AD minus BC that means 19 into 50 minus 13 into 10 why I have written 13 into 10 why because minus 13 into minus 10 plus it is going to become okay write down 5 9s are 45 5 1s are 5 plus 4 9 950 will become okay minus 130 0 2 8 is it correct 0 2 8 yes 820 determinant has come okay now you see individually determinant A determinant B we will find we will multiply finally then that should come 820 okay let us do first determinant A we will find determinant A is equal to 4 plus 6 that is equal to 10 is it okay AD minus BC minus BC means here minus is there that is why plus BC it is going to become 6 4 plus 6 determinant A. One step it has come you see next go for determinant B determinant B you saw 40 plus 42 is it okay 8 5s are 40 minus of minus means plus 7 6 are 42 42 that means how it will become 82 okay now you find determinant A into determinant B is equal to 82 into 10 that is equal to 820 okay now we can say that we have verified this theorem 820 has come LHS is equal to RHS hence proved like that we can write we have verified this theorem that means determinant of AB is equal to determinant A into determinant B you call into but you need not write into simply you write determinant A determinant B but these are multiplication or else you can say determinant of multiplication AB is equal to multiplication of determinant A and determinant B okay that also you can write spelling and all okay this is also one theorem okay now what we do final concept inverse we go okay but how to find this inverse we will find inverse and we will take one example also okay see I am writing inverse how to write inverse how derivation of inverse how it has come you see already we have gone one theorem A into adjoint A is equal to adjoint A into A that is equal to determinant A into I this verification we have done okay already in this class only okay now what I am going to do you see here determinant A is nothing but a scalar that means scalar I can send any side this side also I can send scalar okay I am sending a scalar you see how I am sending A into 1 by determinant A into adjoint A okay that is equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A into A that is equal to I why I only because this A we have sent this side okay this we have taken proof already sir not proof we have verified earlier okay now you see this this determinant is like a scalar one number then that number I have sent equal to this side another side or else we can say I have both sides have divided by determinant A like then determinant are going to get cancelled this side denominator determinant will come okay you see why I have not written adjoint A by determinant A I can write but why I have not written why because see in matrix or determinants division we don't know division we don't know if any division has come you see matrix 1 2 3 4 is there okay if multiplication this is A if 2A means what we do 2 4 6 8 we will write What if 1 by 2 a? Are you going to divide? No, what we are doing, 1 by 2 multiply we are doing. That means 2 by 2. 1 by 2 into 2. 1 by 2 into 4. 1 by 2 into 6. 1 by 2 into 8. Finally, what will come? Here 1 will come, here 2 will come, here 3 will come, here 4 will come. Okay? You understand now? That means, see, entire the matrix directly you are not going to divide. Here adjoint A is nothing but a matrix only, na? That is why what we are doing, we are multiplying 1 by, you write and multiply 1 by 2 into A. That is the division. Division means this only. Okay, directly you are not going to divide in matrices or determinants, whatever it may be. Okay, now you see this side multiplication, this side division. Division means 1 by A into, okay, denominator. Or else we can say here numerator, it comes to denominator. Okay. Now what you are going to observe here? Now shall I write this A, 1 by A adjoint A, 1 by A adjoint A as B? Let B is equal to 1 by A adjoint A. Then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. Is it okay? First you see, I have considered 1 by A adjoint A as B. AB is equal to BA is equal to I. Okay. Now, already we know inverse of matrix formula. If AB is equal to BA is equal to I, then B is inverse of A. This formula already we know in matrices. AB is equal to BA is equal to I, then B is inverse of A. Then finally what we can write? Finally we can write like this. A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant A adjoint A. That means into 1 by A determinant A into adjoint A is A inverse. Okay? Okay, here B. Okay, now what we do, we take one example, we will find this. Why? Because see, how to find determinant we have to find, and cofactors also have to find. Cofactors, transposed cofactor matrix you have to write, that is going to be called as adjoint. Adjoint you have to find. Then outside 1 by determinant, that means 1 by 2 or 1 by 3, this is a number only you have to write. If that number is divisible, then you send directly inside. That is going to give your A inverse. Okay. Now, see this procedure. In this procedure, see, what is the requirement? See, non-singular it should be. That means first you have to find determinant. Determinant should not come 0. If determinant comes 0, means singular. Singular means 1 by 0, undefined or infinity. Undefined. Then there is no inverse, like you can write and close. Okay. If determinant is not equal to 0, then you can proceed. First you have to find determinant. Okay. We will take directly. Now see, elementary operation you need not to do. But cofactor method you can do inverse. This is a different method. Okay. Let us find. One example we will take. 3 by 3 only. Okay. 3 by 3 one matrix. A is equal to 1, 0, minus 3. 2, 4, minus 1, 5, minus 2, 0. Okay. Now this is a matrix. Okay. First, if you want to find, see, we are finding A inverse, but I am not written. We are finding A inverse. See, first step, you have to find a determinant. You find a determinant. If determinant is not equal to 0, then you proceed. If determinant is equal to 0, then we will change. Why? Because there is no other option. If you want to find A inverse means, for us, if they give you examiner, A determinant A is equal to 0 means there is no inverse, like you write and close. Okay? Let me find A inverse. Sorry, determinant. Determinant A is equal to, you see, plus 1 into, okay, 0 minus 2. That means if I go this side, then minus 0 plus of minus 3, that means minus 3 only. Minus 3, okay, minus 4, minus 20. Okay, now you see minus 2 will become, and minus 24 into minus 3 plus 72. That means 72 minus 2 plus 70. That means determinant A is not equal to 0. A inverse exists.
Okay, determinant A, 70 has come, not 0. That means A inverse exists. The determinant also you have to use by this formula. Now you find all cofactors. Okay? Cofactors how to find and all I have already explained. Let us find cofactors, then adjoint A cofactor and this divided by 70 you have to write. Let us write A11, cofactor 11. See, 11 means plus will come. 0 minus 2. That means minus 2. That means finally you write minus 2. That's all. 0 minus 2. Minus 2. Okay. Now A 1 2. Minus will come.
1 2.
Minus. Okay.
Okay.
A 1 2 cofactor we are finding. Minus I have kept. Why? Because A 1 2. And see 0 plus 5. 0 minus of minus 5 plus 5. 0 plus 5 means 5. 5 will come, but already outside minus is there. Okay, A13. Okay, minus 4. See, A13 first plus you keep. Minus 4. A13 plus. Minus 4. Minus 20. That means how it will come? Minus 24 will come. Then directly I am writing minus 24. Okay. Minus 24. Okay. Now, rather than here, I am writing here. Why? Because these three I will write vertically afterwards. Okay. Now, A21 means minus you have to write. Minus if you write, see, 0 minus 6. 0 minus 6. Minus 6 will come. Minus 6, minus of minus 6 plus 6. Okay. A22. Plus you keep first outside, wipe the 2 plus 2, plus 0, minus of minus 15, plus 15, plus 15, plus 15 means plus 15 only, okay? Okay, now you go for A23 if you go, okay, now you see minus 2, 0, minus 2, why? Because here minus is already there, minus 2 will come, that means plus 2 it will become, okay? Already one minus is there outside, there, but a 0, yes, minus 2, A23, yes, this one, that means minus 2, minus 0, that means minus 2, minus already outside, minus of minus 2, plus 2, okay. Now we go for A31. A3 plus 1 plus will come. Okay. Okay. Now you see 0 minus of minus 12 plus 12. Plus 12 only you write. A32 minus will come. Minus 1 plus 6. Is it okay? Minus 1 plus 6. Minus of minus 6 plus 6. Minus 1 plus 6 means plus 5. Plus 5 minus means minus 5. You write minus 5. A33. Plus will come faster. Okay. Then 4. Minus 0. 4 minus 0. 4 only. Plus 4. That's all. Plus 4. Okay. Now you see. These are the cofactors. Adjoint how can you write? I am writing adjoint, you see here. Adjoint A is equal to these horizontal, you have to write in vertical position. Minus 2, minus 5, minus 24, 6, 15, 2, 12, minus 5. 4. This is adjoint A. Why? Because these cofactors transposed. Okay? Transposed matrix of cofactors is adjoint A. A adjoint A. Okay, now you write A inverse.
A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. Determinant A, how much it has come? 70. 1 by 70. You write 1 by 70 minus 2, 6, 12, minus 5, 15, minus 5, minus 24, 2, 4.
Like this you can write and close. Okay. Or else you can send this 70 inside also. 70 inside, you see, if this is a small number and inside big numbers are there, then these will go and divide carefully. If you send now this 70 inside, all nonsense is going to become. Why? Because all fractions are going to become. Rather than writing all fractions inside, then you keep one fraction outside and leave like this only. Okay. Okay, now we have done.
Okay.
See, we have finished this concepts. We will start 4.5 exercise questions in the next class. Okay. Thank you very much.